Welcome to the fifth part of the Web Login System series. So far, we have completed the login form, user registration form with MySQL Server integration, and navigation bar with separate forms for admin and user accounts. It is recommended to watch this playlist by clicking on the I button above or in the description. This video will demonstrate a unique feature of new user verification through code. You can use such a system where a client will be granted a code after a certain payment to unlock his or her account. This advanced security feature can be used in many ways. Let's get started.
This is the VS Code screen of our web login system project. Let me adjust the zoom level so it can be prominent. A random code has already been generated while registering a user. First, open the main PHP file to create a table from which the admin can access the list of new users who have not verified their accounts. Check the server database about the column regarding verified users, which should be true after verifying. Start PHP code within the HTML. Very good, the admin form contains all the unverified users. Okay, we will work on the last user's code to build a validation system. So far, simply the user login opens the user home page. The message will appear on the top of the login form. Here it is in the login form PHP section where we put the required message for the user not verified and a link to open the form for verification. For a better understanding, these comments will help you out. Let's create a verification PHP file. We will complete the coding later on and meanwhile, it should be open so the process can be tested. Move back to the login form. There are a few things to do here like a message and login form navigation button. By the way, you can press Alt-Shift and F for the proper format of a PHP code. Install an extension, of course. Everything seems to be good. Let's test this now. the information message has appeared, but the second line for the navigation link has not. Let's dig out the reason. This message was not placed after the first message line. Oops, an error at line 190 due to the message was not defined as null or empty. Okay, good to go again. Fine, the activation code has appeared as well. As you can see, the verification form has been opened. Move on to working on the activation form. Copy the Bootstrap 5 CDN to the form. Let's test the form. We have not applied any CSS so far. The main theme of our forms except the login form is almost the same, so for time saving, you can use the same register CSS file for styling the verification form as well. Copy the local CSS file from the register form. That's it, all the CSS applied, but what happened to the submit button? Let's see. The label is missing only. Nicely done. Move on to the admin form, copy the user code, and try to apply to unlock the user account. We have not applied server-side PHP coding, so the verified column can be true after successful submission of the code. As you can see, it is still zero. code required to copy again from the admin account. As you can see, there is an issue at line 8. Let's see where is that. Got it, it is due to the name reference that we copied from above. Great work! It is done. Now, let's see if the user is unlocked and can be logged in. That's it, the user is verified and logged in and the user's home page is opened. Skillheader deserves to be subscribed to, liked, shared, and commented on. Isn't it? If you think so, please do so. See you in the next exciting video.